Let's understand OCI architecture. In OCI architecture, the first thing you will notice is region. These are nothing but Oracle data centers at different places in the world. They have data centers in US Phoenix, Aspen, another one is in Toronto, they have in Frankfurt and Tokyo, and there might be future data centers coming up. All these data centers are connected with each other through Oracle Fast Connect. So when you enroll for OCI, by default, you are given a region, or you can prefer a region based on your geopolitical or whatever need you have. In few cases, like if you are working for a government organization, there might be a need that the data center should be within your country. So based on that, you will select which data center, which region you will have your cloud instance. And once you got your region assigned, so let's say, for example, you got your US Phoenix region assigned. After you log into OCI, you have a username, you got assigned region. Next comes virtual cloud network. This is the virtual network on top of the physical network which is designed in Oracle data center. For virtual cloud network, two important things for you to be able to connect to your instance under that virtual cloud network are internet gateway and dynamic routing gateway. Internet gateway is required if you want your instances within that virtual cloud network to be able to connect to internet. If you want to have your instance wide open and make it possible to connect to that instance through internet, then you need internet gateway. If you have Oracle Fast Connect, or you want to connect to that instance only through your own on-premise network, your LAN and VPN, then you don't need internet gateway. You need dynamic routing gateway. So through dynamic routing gateway, you can create IPSec Tunnel, or you can have Oracle Fast Connect, and you can directly connect to your instance, and it will not be exposed through internet. Within virtual cloud network, you will have availability domains. These are subgrouping of instances, or you can call a subgrouping of bare metal machines or virtual machines within a data center. And each availability domain is configured under a subnet. So availability domain 1 has a subnet 1, availability domain 2 has subnet 2. So like that, you will find under one region, you will get at least 4 availability domains. So when you create an instance, it will ask you, right, in which availability domain you want to create the instance. All these availability domains are connected with each other through a very fast connection. I think it's somewhere around 1 Gbps or more. That's how fast they are connected with each other. So as far as the networking goes, each availability domain has its own subnet. And how do you connect to those availability domains? Any instance in these availability domains will have routable and security list as kind of, you can say, firewall to be able to connect to that. So consider this, your virtual cloud network, which is used by these availability domains, will have root table and security list. Security list you can consider as a firewall rule. Through security list, you can say which IP address can connect to this instance, and root table, which say which type of connection is allowed for this instance. Root table will guide whether this instance can be connected through internet gateway or DRG or both. That kind of rule is written in root table rule. And under this availability domain, under this subnet, you create instances. There are two kind of instances. So when you create an instance in OCI, it will give you public IP address as well as private IP address. It is up to you whether you want a public IP address or not. Public IP address is required if you want to be able to connect your instance through Internet Gateway. If you don't want to be able to connect your instance through Internet Gateway, then you don't need public IP. You can just have private IP and connect through dynamic routing gateway. I tell you what is the best practice we followed. Each instance should have public and private IP, and your root table connected to that instance will guide whether it can be connected through Internet Gateway or DIG. So at least you have a flexibility. Let your instance have both public IP and private IP. And if you don't want that instance to be able to connect through internet, then in the root table, you don't mention the root rule which allows connection through internet gateway. You only mention the root rule which allows connection through DRG. So that's what I was talking about. For public instance to be able to access with a public IP, it is run through internet gateway, and private instance connected through dynamic routing gateway. We will talk more about dynamic routing gateway when we will talk about IPSec tunnel connections and Oracle Fast Connect. Oh yeah, we didn't talk about object storage. So object storage lies somewhere outside these subnets. This is funny. Connect an instance to object storage, if it is a public IP and you have not set up the DRG and IPSec tunnel, you have to go through internet gateway. So it looks like object storage is kept somewhere else in Oracle OCI, and if you want to connect to that, you have to go through internet gateway. You can also have something called service gateway, and you don't have to go through internet gateway. You can set up a service gateway, and through service gateway you can directly connect, so your data does not go on internet. You can directly connect your instance through service gateway and then object storage, so it remains within Oracle network. It does not go to internet gateway. We will configure service gateway and we will use it in this course, so you will get a full exposure to that. So that's what happens within a region. This is all. But wait a minute, we did not talk about tenancy and compartment. Where does that lie? Let's consider you have more than one region, right? And this is quite possible. When you subscribe to OCI, you might end up using more than one region. You might have your live instance in one region and your DR instance in other region. So that is possible. So consider you have two regions. How does tenancy map in this? Tenancy grouping is at a higher level. It's just a logical grouping. You have one tenancy and you can subscribe to as many regions as you want within that tenancy. When you log in, you are given a tenancy, and that tenancy is assigned to your user, and under that tenancy you can subscribe to as many regions as you want. How about compartment? Compartment is also another logical grouping. So you can have compartment 1, compartment 2. It is up to you how you design your compartments. Compartments can be considered as a logical grouping based on your need. So it's up to you, how do you want to configure your compartments. You can have two separate compartments, or you can make them all in one compartment. You can have one compartment and your live instance, your DR instance, both can belong to the same compartment, even though those instances are on different regions. That is possible. So it's purely up to you, how do you design your compartment. So that's it. That's about OCI architecture as of now. We will take a deeper dive on each component in future lectures. I will see you in next lecture.